Welcome to part two of this ProCamera tutorial series for beginners. To begin editing, open a photo in your ProCamera library, then tap here to open the Editing Studio. This is the main menu, which gives you access to a wide range of tools to make creative adjustments to your iPhone photos. Your menu might have a few more options than you see here, but don't worry about that. I'll cover those additional options later in this video. The filter presets opens first by default, but you can edit in whichever order you like. For instance, to crop and straighten your photo, tap here. There are three options for you to choose from. Let's tap Rotate first. You can tap here to rotate the photo, but there's no need for me to do that with this photo. And tapping here allows you to mirror the photo, which I also don't need. I just wanted to point these options out to you. In case your photo is crooked, you can straighten it here. Just swipe to adjust the angle, and use the grid to help with the alignment. You have plenty of preset crops located here in various aspect ratios to choose from. Tap to select one. I'm going to go with the golden ratio format located right here. Tap the aspect ratio again to flip your photo's vertical format to a horizontal one, or the other way around, depending on the format of your photo. Tap again to reset the crop and start over. I'm going to tap once more to reapply the chosen aspect ratio. Now I can simply drag one of the points to adjust the crop. Notice how the aspect ratio remains the same as I drag. Tap, hold, and drag to reposition the entire crop as needed. You can also double tap your photo anytime to undo the crop. Now let's crop freestyle. It's very easy, just tap here to unlock. Notice now how the aspect ratio is no longer locked like it was before, and I'm able to drag any of the 8 points to fine-tune my crop into a custom format. At this point, I'm happy with the crop, so I'll tap here to save. You never have to worry about losing access to your original photo, by the way, since your edited version is always saved together along with the original untouched photo. Tap here to reveal your original photo file, and tap again to open it. I'm not quite done editing my photo just yet, so I'll reopen my recently edited photo and make some additional edits. Tap once more to enter the editing studio. We start again in the filter presets. Simply swipe over your photo to begin browsing the filters, or swipe over the preview images here to browse more quickly. There are over 80 of them to choose from, and the filters are a very quick and easy way to add style and mood to your photo. As you can see, the filters have also been organized into various filter packs here for your convenience. Once you find one you like, you can also swipe up or down over your photo to adjust the filter. I'm going to leave it at 100%. The toggle switch here removes your edit so that you can quickly revert back to your original photo if needed. You can also tap once more to bring your edits back. I'm happy with the result and don't want to make further changes, but this time I'll long press over the Save button to open up some new options. Here I can choose to save as a new image or to save the new image under a different file format. Now let's have a look at a different kind of photo, which was taken in ProCamera's portrait mode. Now when we open the Editing Studio, we see a new depth editing option available right here. There's also a perspective correction tool, but we'll look at that one a little bit later. With the reticle placed on top of your chosen subject, swipe up or down to adjust the amount of background blur. You can now tap the background to bring that area into focus. On newer iPhone models, you'll also be able to adjust the blur on objects in the foreground. I like having the background blurred in this photo, so I'll tap again on the bird and make my final adjustment. This time, instead of saving, I'm going to jump right into the advanced tools located right here to make more adjustments to my photo. There are lots of easy-to-use tools available for you here to fine-tune your photo. For instance, tap here if you want to make the colors a bit more vibrant. There are also tools for more advanced users, like the Curves tool for correcting exposure problems, adjusting color balance, and creating stylized looks. Tap here to toggle between the isolated color channels to make adjustments to a specific range of colors. In case you want to undo an edit you've made, tap the tool once more, and tap again to bring the edit back. The editing studio is unique in that it's a completely non-destructive workflow, meaning you can always undo edits as you please, even after you save a photo. Now let's add some artistic effects to the photo. Tap here to open the lab. The lab allows you to experiment with unique artistic effects, just in case you want to add a little more flair to your photo. In the case of the vignette effect, which is where we are now, we can swipe up and down as well as left to right to apply the effect. Take your time to explore the lab and experiment with adding multiple effects on top of one another for a truly unique result. When we tap to see the original photo here, you can see what a truly dramatic difference editing can make to a photo. If you take a photo in RAW or ProRAW format, you'll notice an extra option in the editing studio located here. Photos in RAW format offer even more creative freedom in post-processing. You can combine the dedicated RAW tools with our regular set of tools, filters, and effects, which I've just shown you, to realize your artistic vision. As before, just swipe up and down, and in some cases, left to right to add the edit. Last but not least, the perspective correction tool located here is included with the optional ProCamera Up feature bundle. You can freely swipe up or down and left to right to adjust the perspective as you wish. Tap autocorrect here and let ProCamera automatically fix the perspective distortion for you. Tap here to see how the original photo has been adjusted and cropped. I hope this tutorial has helped you understand the basics of ProCamera's comprehensive editing studio. I encourage you to take a more extensive dive, get creative, and experiment with your own photos in the editing studio. And if you missed it, there is a previous tutorial available for you now where you can learn about focus and exposure and the basics of the capture screen. Thanks for watching.